In the next speaker is Julieta Bray. Her presentation title is Andreessen and OCP in the site.
Thank you for the invitation. Donc, hello. Donc, anterior segment OCT, especially in infectious keratitis. So, main issues are in the management of infectious keratitis. We have some issue. We should do an early etiological diagnosis. We should monitor our patient to detect early improvement or worsening in order to adjust the treatment. How can OCT help us improve the management of infectious keratitis? In real life, we do the clinical examination with a plain slit lamp, sometimes with a photo. So the photo slit lens is very useful because we can follow our patients with many doctors. We can detect clinical changes at an early stage. But the limit is two dimensions. So spectral domain anterior segment OCT appears to be a non-invasive tool, and it can be useful for our patients. So in our hospital, we use the Optoview XR Avanti. We have a nice field of view, 8 millimeters. The teeth is 250 micrometer, quite good resolution, 8 micrometer. It permits 3D OCT pachymetry. So we are used to do some cross-sectional images, one horizontal cornea centered light, one vertical, one raster cornea, and one pachymetry. And for small lesions, we do one horizontal line and one vertical line on the lesion. Soliman presented a correlation between what we observe in our clinical practice and what we observe in OCT. So we can say that stromal infiltrate is an hyperreflective lesion. What is also important is how to detect the necrosis with small cystic spaces in the lesion. So they detect, we can see also here the small cystic spaces. What is also important is general parameters, the central corneal thickness, the corneal thickness at the level of the infiltrate, the infiltrate width, the infiltrate thickness. Donc, in our hospital, we found it very interesting to etiological diagnosis. For example, here we see a white plaque. Sometimes, with just an image at the slit lamp, we cannot see the white plaque. So it's very useful because with this white plaque, we can think about fungal keratitis. Without the OCT, we would have more efforts. For this patient, we have a plain keratitis under contact lens.
we can say, oh, it's just the toxicity of the products. But with OCT, we can see also keratoneuritis, and that is also useful. And we have the diagnosis of acantamoeba. We have also keratoneuritis in viral keratitis, but here the context helps us. Here it's another patient with a large defect, with a large epithelial defect. We do the OCT, and in the with the OCT we can see a big edema. So we can also think about acantamoeba keratitis. It's very useful in post-LASIK for to analyze the infiltrate. Here the infiltrate extends before the interface and after the interface. So it's it seems to be an infectious keratitis. After the scraps, it was a Streptococcus pneumoniae. For another case, we saw post-LASIK. 15 days later, we saw an infiltrate with an extensions in the stroma and in the and to the epithelium. Keratic precipitate, sometimes it's very difficult to see them at the sleep time when there's a big edema. So here we can see a keratic precipitate, and we can evoke the viral etiology. Interest in assessing severity is also a particularity for the OCT. Perhaps not for this case, but when we do an OCT, we can see the cystic spaces and is a very bad prognosis. Fungal keratitis, if we saw some white plaque behind the lesion, it's also not a good prognosis. Interest in follow-up to stop the treatment. So it's a fungal keratitis. 10 days later, the infiltrate is very clear, but at the OCT, we have still an hyperreflective lesion, so we cannot stop so quickly the treatment. So in summary, we can say that the OCT is very useful for fungus and acantamoeba keratitis. Limits are many artifacts for severe lesions with the shadow cone, no eye tracker, so it's not very reproducible, no direct measurement of the infiltrate in the 3D mode. Advantages are also here with an objective tool in the monitoring infectious keratitis. It's non-invasive. So OCT appears to be a complementary tool for the management of infectious keratitis in acantamoeba, in fungus. In future, we expect also an IR resolution, an eye tracker, as in retina OCT, perhaps coupled to the slip lamp, and after that, an analysis of the lesion with software. Thank you very much.
Thank you for a very nice talk. The primary problem I face with my bacterial infection is to know when I can taper the fortified antibiotics, because toxicity is a problem. Is there, and we depend only on clinical signs. Is there any hard sign we can get from doing an anterosegment OCT where we can taper the antibiotics faster?
Perhaps with a diminution of the cystic spaces, but for bacterial, it's also the same dimensions of the infiltrate at the slit lamp. The dimension in OCT are the same. So for just to monitor the infiltrate for bacterial keratitis, it's not a good tool. It's useful to quantify the edema, to see a white plaque behind the endothelium, to see some cystic spaces, but just to analyze the infiltrate and the diminution, the OCT is not good.
OCT is used for assessing the radial keratoneuritis. So how much time it takes for this lesion to get disappeared in the follow-up anti-segment OCT so that you can taper the steroids if anything is being initiated?
Well, for the viral keratitis is very important because we treat with the criteria of treatment are the edema, the keratic precipitates, and that is useful, but for bacterial, not very. Yes, for acanthamoeba keratitis and fungal keratitis. Thank you.
Juliette, do you image everybody that has a corneal infection, or do you select the patients that you image?
The first day at the entrance, we image all the patients, and then it depends of the microbiological results. If it's a bacteria, at the end of the hospitalization, we do another OCT. But for fungal keratitis or acanthamoeba keratitis or viral keratitis, every 2 days we do an OCT.
Any other questions?